What is going on, guys? My name is Triforce Addiction. After so many countless days and nights of grinding and grinding and even more grinding, I have finally achieved diamond camo for every single weapon in Call of Duty Mobile. I have to say this right now, it feels so good to be free. Honestly, when you played in Shipment 1944 for an entire month, ever since Season 13 came out, yeah, it could honestly be like one of the most exhausting things in the world. It seemed like every single time I got into Shipment, like every single time when I was trying to get those 10 kills and I got into a game and just left, it got more and more exhausting, like the more weapons you did. Like at first it was like whatever, but then, like, you know, like after 20 guns, like you start to lose your patience. So there were times where I did take a few days break. I could have got this done sooner if I had like far more patience, but I mean, like, how much more patience can you have for getting like 50 weapons diamond? I do have to say, like, after being in Shipment for pretty much a month straight, I had a lot of problems readjusting to like just the basic multiplayer maps, because when you just have been in one map for like an entire month, you kind of lose, like, I don't know, you kind of lose your map awareness on every other map, like firing range or something like that. It took me a while to readjust to everything again. I had to set up all my classes, which took life. So yeah, it was kind of like a big transition, like after finishing all this. But it was really nice to like show off all your diamond weapons to everyone. Of course, everyone has at least gotten diamond for like one weapon, you know? It doesn't really take a long time to get one. Especially if you're trying to grind it like the normal way and, you know, just actually finishing the matches instead of leaving them after the 10 kills. So, you know, someone at this point has to have diamond on something. It can either be the Locus or, you know, the QXR or something. You know, after I was done with this whole grind, my friend invited me to, like, his lobby. And he asked me, like, where I've been, like, this entire time. I explained everything to him. And he's like, dude, you got diamond for everything? I'm like, yeah. And he's like, dude, like, you need a life, basically. That's pretty much what he told me. And, I didn't get offended, of course. And I told him, like, dude, yeah, you're right, man. Like, this grind was probably more exhausting than it should be. I mean, like, in Modern Warfare, I felt like the Obsidian challenges were a lot more lenient, because you were able to stack up the challenges, like, in a single match. So if you got 10 kills, you could do that again in the same match. Here, for some reason, you could only do the 10 kills once, leave the match, and then go to another one. So that's something I really did not like about this whole entire grind. If the game was put up so you could, you know, progress more than once in a single game, I would have been in, like, other maps. I wouldn't have just been in Shipment the entire time. And, like, honestly, that was my biggest gripe with this entire grind. And I'm sure a lot of you guys will agree with me. This thing was a little bit longer than it should have been. You guys have to keep in mind, like, while the diamond camo looks stunning on pretty much every single gun, like, I know the diamond camo is a very renowned camo in this game, or, like, in just Call of Duty in general. But you have to remember that, like, this is the first time that diamond camo was given a different set of challenges. You know, typically, you know, if you're playing on, like, in Infinity Ward games or on, on Black Ops games, normally you would have to get gold on every single gun in a category in order to unlock diamond. But this time around, we just had to use a gun for such a long time in order to unlock it, more time than it probably should take. Because, like I said, you're not allowed to progress multiple times in a single match. You know, if you're gonna make the challenges this long-winded, you better have some sort of special reward at the end. I mean, yeah, like, diamond camo is a pretty cool reward for every weapon. But what I'm talking about is, like, I think it's time that we get a true Dark Matter. I know, like, it's been confirmed on Reddit, like, in one of the community updates, they did say that it is not out of the realm of possibility. You know, we can always get DM Ultra or some sort of endgame camo, but I think this part is very important, because this grind took way too long for, like, almost nothing to come out of it, you know? Like, I felt like this was actually a more sizable grind than Damascus. Let's be honest here, guys. Like, Damascus is cool and everything, but, like, it's not worth getting gold on every single weapon. I think that's why not a lot of people have Damascus, because it's just not appealing. You know, like, I understand they want to copy a little bit off Modern Warfare, but why couldn't they just copy off Black Ops Cold War or something, you know? We could have had Dark Aether or Dark Matter Ultra or something like that. but instead we got some stationary camo that lost its shine. Yeah, it got redesigned, it looks a little bit better, but I mean, without the shine, it's just like, it feels like a common camo. Damascus looks so bad to the point where people are starting to take it off and use something else. I mean, my friend Ra, when he was grinding for a diamond, he wouldn't even have a skin on his weapon, not even gold or platinum. So like, yeah, a lot, like some people, or like even a lot of people are turning away from the camo because they really messed it up during season 13. And like back in season 12 or season 11, that's when it looked really good. But like now it's like without the shine, it's basically a useless camo. I felt like diamond should have been the endgame camo for this. So that's why I say for people that may grind for diamond on all weapons in the future, they should be rewarded with a special dark matter animated type camo. And there's multiple variations of dark matter, but I'll get into that later. So now I want to talk about the totals of getting every single weapon diamond. Like I'm talking about the kills and the games like as a grand total. So the way I calculated it was, of course, I added pretty much the total games of all the weapons together, as well as all the kills together. When it comes to the launchers, really all you need is 200 UAVs. For the melee weapons, there's not really a set amount of games that is required to get those 500 kills. It's going to be different for everyone. Some will get like in 10 games, some will get it like in other amounts. So it's not really clear how many games it actually takes to really get all the melee weapons diamond, which is just 500 kills each. But I did manage to count that. So the grand total amount of kills that you are going to have to get for every single weapon, like put together, is 56,900 kills. So the grand total amount of games that you are going to have to play for all the diamond weapons combined is a grand total of 6,190 plus games. I put the plus there because, like I said, the melee weapons and the launchers don't really have a set amount of games. It's really, like, it really all depends on how fast you could progress through all those challenges. So for those of you guys who want to get the diamond launchers, I do recommend, you know, just having it as a secondary while you're just grinding for the weapon that you want to grind for. So that if, like, if anyone ever wants to call in a UAV, you could just shoot it down immediately, have it count. And this is one of those situations where it doesn't matter how many times you shoot down UAV, it's always going to count. So you could do that more than once in a single game. Anyways, we're going to wrap up this video right now. We're not going to have a showcase on this video. On the next one, we are. That's mainly because I don't want to, you know, have too much time into this video. You know, I don't want to have like 30 minutes of footage. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for some more Diamond content, as well as just overall COD Mobile content. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you.